Brett, how many approximately, these are club lambs, this is what you do for the breeding end of it, correct?
Right.
And approximately how many do you have, how many ewes and lambs do you lamb out at this time of year?
There's approximately 350 to 400 ewes that are bred, and we'll have between 525 and 575 lambs born.
Okay, and then do you just do the lambing one time a year, or do you have them set up in different...
We lamb one time a year. We'll start in the middle of December and lamb through March.
Okay, and I understand recently you got a chance to use the Udderly Easy Milker.
Yeah, we just got it a few days ago, and I got to try it out. I was the first one to use it, and it worked great.
We went ahead and put it up. We start sucking the teat down slowly, put the pressure on it, and as soon as the milk starts, we stop pumping, and you can see how fast it's filling into the bottle. Okay, now we're getting ready to take the bottle off. You just tip the bottle back towards the pump, the handle, and it releases the vacuum and comes right off the teat. Very good. Two different ways that we can do this, and everybody does it a little differently. If you're going to pour the milk or the colostrum out of the bottle, we'll go ahead and remove the insert, pull that out of there first, off the top of the number one, and then you can just go ahead and, like you're going to go ahead and pour it in the back of there. Or at this point, you can go ahead and put the tube in on the tubing syringe right into the bottle without even taking it apart, aspirating it that way, and go ahead and pull up ever how many ounces that you need. How many do you normally give them, Tom?
On a bigger lamb, six or seven, seven and a half. This is a 5 ounce syringe, and so I always give them one. Even a small lamb will take one of these, and if you got a nice size lamb, a big old lamb, you give 7.5, 8 ounces maybe, but
right.
You always give a full syringe, unless it's a very tiny lamb.
Super. Okay. Well, that's great then, and then how... If you get that right into the lamb after it's directly after it's born, that's the best time, correct?
I do it right away. I don't even wait for the lamb to stand up. Sometimes I'll do the first lamb before she ever has her second lamb just to get it done and get it over with. And then I'll go ahead and put those in a lambing jug, and I know that colostrum's already in the lamb and ready to go. Well, the powdered milk has gotten so expensive anymore that even one 25 bucket of powdered milk won't be enough to raise a lamb, and it's running, you know, $45, $50 for a bucket of that powder. So it's not economic to use that. So you can take milk from another ewe, or perhaps you've got a ewe that's got a single lamb on that's an excellent milker. You can keep stealing milk from her all the time to supplement other lambs that you might have in the barn. And so this is one of the main reasons I think this is a very economic way to supplement lambs without buying the powdered milk.
Well, and it's very fast, very efficient. And the other thing of it, too, is also the cleanliness of being able to pull this milk. You're not getting any manure or anything else into the... Because you're taking it directly and tubing those babies directly or right away with it also, aren't you?
Exactly. And what we've done is taken milk from different ewes and just stockpile it, pour it in a gallon jug or whatever, a reservoir tank you might call it, and save it till we need it later on that day or that evening. Or if you have a set of triplet lambs that need to be supplemented, you can take extra milk very easily from two or three other ewes to get extra milk. And I don't buy any powdered milk. And I've got over 500 lambs and... I just don't buy any powdered milk. I can always take milk from other ewes that are milking extra good.
Okay. So what I do when I'm getting ready to milk here is I'm going to kind of put my hand on her udder and kind of try and center that udder out away from the back leg. That way I just kind of tip this in and I start squeezing to get my suction. Once I have the suction, then I just hold it, the milker down straight, and then the milk just streams in. There you go. I just wait for it to fill up, and if it slows down, I give it another squeeze, start things back up.
Go ahead and pump it again, and we'll get that flow. You can just really see, I've got it on telephoto, and really see it coming in there now. You always want to make sure you have that bottle tipped back towards the pump, too, so you don't lose your vacuum on there. And you can just see that milk stream going steadily into the bottle now. Okay, there again, and then just tip the bottle back towards the pumping handle. It drops right off the teat, and there it is. So you're going to get a good, you'll get a good 8 ounces off this first drawing, won't you?
Yeah, if I'm lucky, I'll get 8 ounces off of each side.
Uh-huh.
When I milk, I try not to milk too much more than that. I usually,
right.
You know, uh-huh. If I'm going to milk her again, I might wait till this evening, about 12 hours later.
Okay.
Give her a chance.
How often do you feed him?
About every 3 to 4 hours.
How's the Udderly Easy helped you in the fact that you haven't had to use any milk replacer?
Oh, it's been so nice. It's easy because I can take the milk out of the fridge and just warm it up.
Uh-huh.
In a little warm water, and in about 5 minutes I'll come out and I'll feed her, and I don't have to have the mess of making my own milk for the lamb, which is nice. And as the lamb gets a little older, I won't even warm it up much. I'll probably, you know, just set them out on the counter at room temperature, and she'll drink that. With all the cold weather we've had, I usually like to warm it up just a tad.
It's Pierce McKinney's farm. His homestead's been in the family since 18, many, many, 100 and some years. He was born and raised in this house.
1832. All the families, every generation is buried back there.
Wow. 1832, huh?
Uh-huh. Farm was bought in 1828, but because of the, there wasn't a, it was a land grant, and we have John Adams' signature. I don't know if Alice showed it to you, but still, it framed President John Adams when he granted the land to my great-great-grandfather.
God, that is really
Isn't
something.
Isn't that neat?
Yeah.
Come on!
That's him, huh, Wheeler Dealer? Well, he's something to look at, ain't he? Because it's Udderly Easy?
Look at him. Look at him.
Yeah, it sure is.
Isn't it?